بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers, my sisters, a very, very great and grand turnout at this beautiful historic iftar here in Birmingham. We ask Allah to accept it from us. In order for us to be able to achieve something like this in the correct way, we need to be relatively selfless. We need to consider others. When we are seated, we always need to sit where we make sure we have not occupied more than one space, and at the same time ensure consideration for others. When I sit and look at the lives of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I always draw inspiration by the fact that they gave preference to others over themselves. And when I look at that quality alone, I think that it was a quality that Allah had kept in them in order for this deen, the religion, the faith, the goodness to be spread far and wide. They always gave preference to others. Look at what Allah Almighty says about the Ansar. يُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً. Even though they themselves had or were in a condition known as khasasa, they had a dire need for something, they gave preference to others over their own dire needs. And so subhanallah, we learn that. Look, in the month of Ramadan, and we have the last day or two of the month of Ramadan, we must ensure that our hearts are not filled with selfishness. We're not selfish or even miserly when it comes to our wealth and the whatever Allah has bestowed upon us. Every one of us has goodness given by Allah. Allah's blessed us in our own unique way. I always say, you and I are totally unique, completely. No one will ever be like you from the time of Adam right to the end, the last person to exist. No one is going to be like you exactly. No one is going to be like me exactly. Yes, there may be people who are similar, but not identical. Even if outwardly you have twins, they look identical. They're called identical twins, but they're not identical. You look at their thumbprints, you look at the iris, you look at so many different ways of recognition. Allah has kept you unique. Sometimes you have identical twins. Their likes and dislikes are not necessarily the same, different. Yet they love each other. They were born together. They spent time together. 9 months in one womb, subhanallah, rabbil alameen. And here they come out, and you know what? They're different. Allah has created us, all of us, different. Look, from amongst us, the tall, the short, the dark, the fair, the wealthy, the poor, people from different backgrounds, wherever else, whatever else it may be, some of us have this and some have that, some like this, some like that. You know what? Part of the plan of Allah Almighty is to learn to love one and all for the sake of Allah. Do you care for each other? If you do, good news to you. The way to achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, very clearly, Allah Almighty tells us through the blessed lips of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَا يَرْحَمِ اللَّهُ مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمِ النَّاسِ. Allah does not have mercy upon the one who doesn't have mercy upon the people. النَّاس here means all the people. Do you have mercy upon those around you? Starting with those at home, starting with those in your neighborhood, in your circle of relatives, and then going on to everyone. Do you have mercy upon them? Are you a merciful person towards them? If the answer is yes, Allah will then have mercy upon you. Subhanallah. Irhamu man fil ardi yarhamkum man fis sama. Have mercy upon the one, or upon those on earth, and the one in the heavens will have mercy upon you. May Allah Almighty have mercy upon every one of us. So that's a very, very good introduction, because mashallah, as we get together as an ummah, we realize the value of this bond. Do you know Islam is the only religion where it has given a daily importance to a gathering of people? It's called a jama'ah. Jumu'atu wal jama'ah. You have jumu'ah. Jama'ah means to gather. Jumu'ah is the once a week Friday prayer. You must make it there. You have no excuse. There are a few, but generally You don't have an excuse. You must go for Jumu'ah, Jama'ah. You must come together with the people. Why? Allah's given importance for that crowd. Get to know each other, get to greet each other, get to see each other, get to find out about each other, get to see the needs of each other. See the opportunities of doing goodness and do that good, subhanAllah. If you're not going to interact, where are you going to find out about people? And where will people find out that you are in need? For example, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill our needs without the need to turn to anyone. But at the same time, may He use us to help others as well. Then we have the jama'ah on a daily basis. We just completed Salatul Asr with jama'ah. How do we stand? Is that not a lesson? We stand everyone. You stand next to whoever. I don't need to know how much you have, what you have, who you are, and so on, your background, whatever else it may be. I stand next to you. For as long as you came at that time into the masjid, you join the saf, or you join the row exactly where it is. Do you know what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, teaches us? He teaches us to say, Istaw, subhanAllah, Istaw. Can I tell you something on a lighter note? There was an elderly lady from one of the Asian countries. And she asked, I went to Mecca. And I notice every time when the Imam is starting, he says, Istaw. What is he saying? So someone asked her, well, what do you think he's saying? Well, I think he's telling us, I'm about to start praying. Everyone go and check if the stove is off. Make sure everything is closed and switched off. Stove, go and check the stove. No way. It's not that. You don't check the stove. You do make sure that everything is turned off. So you start your salah in order. But that was a laugh. That was such a solid laugh. Because imagine now when you hear the Imam saying stove, your mind is contaminated. Khalas. It's gone. Why? Because he says stow. He doesn't say stow. He says stow. Istow means straighten your rows. Ensure that you're all standing still and proper and straight. Shoulder to shoulder, heel to heel. Subhanallah. وَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا فَتَخْتَلِفَ قُلُوبُكُمْ. Do not be jagged because your hearts will become jagged. Do not be separated because your hearts will be separated. Stand together shoulder to shoulder, mashallah. You stand next to whoever it may be, big muscle, small muscle, no muscle, whatever it is. But you stand shoulder to shoulder. And you know what? That's how it is. You stand together. That's how it's supposed to be. Istawu, i'tadilu, stand still, stand. You're standing in front of Allah Almighty. Then the Imam says, Allahu Akbar. And in sync, everybody raises their hands and ties them. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Amazing. That is a gift of Allah. Allah wants you to do this so many times a day. A day. If you visit your local masjid 5 times a day, and maybe you might be at work for Salat al-Dhuhr and Asr. So let's say 3 times a day you visited this particular masjid. I promise you, you develop a bond stronger than that of your own family. Because you know what? These are your brothers. This is your, subhanAllah, your family, the ummah, together. Why did Allah give importance to it? I've just explained. There are many reasons. Some of them are in order for us to be connected. Now, when I need to be connected with you, I need to compromise a lot of things that are compromisable. Some things are not compromisable. I won't compromise my faith, for example. But I will respect you as a human being. I respect you, and you know this is the line. At the same time, what I must understand generally between us, you will like something, I will like something else. You might want it to be cooler and colder. You might want it to be 12 degrees. Someone else wants it to be 18 degrees, and the uncle in the corner wants it to be 30 degrees. Now what do you do? So every time in Ramadan, I think it's becoming less, but when I was a little bit younger and up to very recently, we used to hear of the wars. Beginning, you hear of the moon wars. Forget about moon wars. Window wars, light wars, sound wars, everything wars. The whole place, there's all wars going on. Subhanallah. People are arguing, should we, shouldn't we open the window? Should we, shouldn't we turn on the light or off the light? Is the sound too loud or too less or what? Subhanallah. It's the house of Allah. Learn to compromise if something is really, really bad. And you feel a lot of people would agree that, for example, this place is freezing. Then we can turn on the air condition, for example. Or we can ensure the heaters are slightly on. If everyone is feeling hot, then why should we compromise for 5 people when the rest of the 500 people feel otherwise? So we are taught that rather, if you're smaller in number, compromise it. Compromise it, it's okay, subhanAllah. If you want to get on with your own family members, you have to have a big heart. This is a month of Ramadan, learn to accommodate people. It's not just you, you're not the only one. And I've said this so many times, you have to make sure that you speak to everyone beautifully, respectfully, consider them, think about them. This evening we'll be having a beautiful meal, inshallah. I'm sure what you're going to get is enough for 2 to 3 people. But at the same time, if need be, and you have to share it with someone, or you want to hold one, and you just want to share the two, you and your brother or your sister, whoever it may be, it's okay, it's fine. When we become selfish, you know what people begin to do? Let me take 5. I'll take 6. I'll put the other 4 behind, 5 behind me, and I'll munch the one and I'll grab my brother, my sister. There are so many people here. SubhanAllah, let's not do that. We shouldn't be that way. It doesn't mean that because things are free, that we should take so many of them. Many have a disease. I think we as humankind generally need to be reminded. When something is free, they say, just take 10. You know, when you're giving out free towels, they say, just take about 10 towels. Why? Because they're giving it. Take your towel or two, and it's okay. Leave the rest for the others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that quality that the Sahaba had. May Allah Almighty grant us the quality that the Sahaba had to be considerate of one another. That's how they loved each other. That's how they stood up for each other. That's how they fought for each other. That's how the Ummah progressed. They also differed in many things. They also had differences of opinion at times, but they didn't allow that to make them hurt and hate and abuse. Rather, they developed themselves beautifully in the companionship of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the same Nabi whom we hope Allah grants us his intercession on the day of judgment. Ameen. So my brothers, my sisters, this month of Ramadan should have taught us a lot. And every month of Ramadan, we should be developing something or another regarding ourselves. When Ramadan comes in, change at least one thing by the time you come out. When you see the next Ramadan, inshallah, you change another thing. Maybe before Ramadan, you change another thing or two. If it's a big thing, change it now. Every one of us knows that we need to change certain things in our lives. If we're not steadfast with prayer, with salah, promise Allah that I'm going to fulfill my 5 daily prayers. The importance given to prayer is more than any other pillar of Islam besides the first one. What is the first one? The declaration that you will never ever worship anyone or anything besides Allah. That's the first pillar of Islam. What is it? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. When you say ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, and when you believe it, and when you work towards it, what does it mean? What is the meaning of ashhadu an la ilaha illallah? I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah. Have you ever sat and thought about what you just said? I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship. That word worthy of worship is of greatest importance. There is none worthy of worship besides Allah. It's a declaration by you and I that I'm never ever going to worship anyone or anything besides Allah, because there is none worthy of even a single droplet of worship besides Allah. That's your declaration of faith. After that, guess what's the most important pillar? It comes next. It's called Salah. Salah is prayer. This afternoon, I was in London speaking at the Jumu'ah, and I spoke about something very interesting. Allah refers to prayer as success. 5 times a day in the Adhan. In fact, more, even in the Iqamah, in preparation for the congregational prayer. Again, it is named success. You've heard the Mu'addin say, Hayya ala salah. Immediately after that, what does he say? Hayya ala al-falah. You've heard that? Calling us towards salah and calling us towards falah. Salah is the prayer, falah is the success. You pray, you succeed. You don't pray, you fail. That's how it works. There's no other way. Even if you think you have succeeded, in Allah's eyes, it is failure. Dismal failure. You might have millions, but in Allah's eyes, you haven't prayed, you've lost everything. That's why the importance is given. Imagine, who wants to succeed? All of us. I want to succeed. So Allah tells you, come to success. What is it? The five daily prayers. That's what he talks about. Let's learn to develop our hearts to the degree that we love the prayer. We enjoy it. We do it for Allah. We take our time. We learn the words. We understand what we're saying. We come up, and when we complete the salah, we sit for a moment remembering Allah. Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam. Oh Allah, you are, and this is the name of Allah, is As-Salam, the source of all peace is Allah. The source of all peace is Allah. And all peace only comes from Allah. That's what we are declaring. Allahumma anta salamu wa minka salamu. Subhanallah. When do we say this? After we have just said Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah in our prayer. We've just ended the prayer. First thing we say, oh Allah, I just said Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. But you know, oh Allah, you are the source of all peace and all peace comes from you. Subhanallah. The peace of my mind, the peace of my heart, the tranquility in my home, the peace around me, the security, whatever else it may be, from Allah. How many times do you say that a day? Every time I end my farad prayer, that's a sunnah dua. It's a sunnah dhikr actually. May Allah Almighty grant us ease. So my brothers, my sisters, from Ramadan, we must come out with at least the five daily prayers in order. In order. That's it. Never be lazy. Never be lazy to please Allah, especially with the five daily prayers. The rest of the things follows. You know why? When you become regular with your five daily prayers, Allah opens the doors of sustenance for you. Allah opens the doors of goodness for you. Allah protects you from immoral behavior and words when you are serious with Allah in prayer.
إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر.
We hear that often, especially if you go to the masjid on a Friday. Salah itself will stop you from immorality and sin and evil. If you are serious about your five daily prayers, you'll enjoy your relationship with Allah. You'll enjoy your days. You don't need to sin in order to be happy and to be pleased and to enjoy temporary pleasure at the expense of your eternal pleasure. It's not even pleasure. It brings about regret. It brings about ultimate regret. We turn to Allah in tawbah. We seek Allah's forgiveness. We ask Allah Almighty to have mercy on us. My brothers and sisters, what a blessed month. What a beautiful month. We've just about almost come to an end of Ramadan. And here we are seated, beautiful evening. We're about to open fast. Remember to pray. Remember to supplicate today. As you are opening your fast, pray for yourselves. Pray for your family members. Pray for the sick and ill of the ummah. Pray for those who've passed on. Pray for those who are struggling across the globe, wherever they are. There are brothers and sisters of ours right now suffering all over. People say, why don't you take the name of this place and that place? It's not fair for the others who are in other places that you have not mentioned. Subhanallah. May Allah Almighty grant us the ability to reach out to one and all with our dua. I tell you, when you pray for others, you achieve inner peace yourself because you care. What did we say right at the beginning? The Sahaba cared for others more than themselves. Oh Allah, I desperately need. But my sister is in even greater desperation and in need. Subhanallah. That's the ummah. That's what the foundation was laid on. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they came over to Medina Munawwara, the Muhajireen, when they saw the Ansar. Allah Almighty instructed the Ansar at one point to share half of their belongings with total strangers whose connection with them was nothing more than La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Allah instructed them, share half of your stuff with this guy. That's it. Are you ready for a total stranger to come about and you have to share half of what you own with this person? It's not easy. It's not easy at all. It's not even easy to embrace someone in our homes today. We ask Allah Almighty to forgive us. We ask Allah Almighty to give us a fraction of that. One fraction of that will solve the problem of the ummah. And thereafter, my brothers and sisters, from this beautiful month of Ramadan, we must learn how to give in the cause of Allah. You give, you receive. You give, you receive. Allah says, "Anfiq ya ibn Adam, anfiq alayk." Spend, O son of Adam, I will spend on you. Spend, O son of Adam, in good causes, I will spend on you. I will give you more and more. مَا نَقَصَ مَالٌ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ. No one's wealth has ever been depleted because of a charity they gave. Ramadan is a month of charity. Have you noticed how all the pillars of Islam come into one month? Obviously, the pilgrimage is outside of Ramadan, but you can do the voluntary, the minor, the umrah. Subhanallah. Have you noticed how everything comes into the month of Ramadan? There is the shahada, which we repeat on a daily basis, pillar number one. The prayers we repeat on a daily basis, the second pillar. The third pillar, we are fasting. The fourth pillar, we are giving zakat. The fifth pillar is slightly outside, but here, at least all four are right here, right now. Hence the blessedness of this powerful, beautiful month. And we are seated here, our hearts are softened next to each other. MashaAllah, we want to witness goodness, we want to change. So change, what is it that you are waiting for? You drop your bad habit, you know what your bad habit is, I know what mine is, you know what yours is, drop it. And if you have a few, at least drop one or two, or all if you can. If not, at least one major thing, change it. Stop it for the sake of Allah. Allah is watching, He knows, He will grant you, He will bless you, He will open your doors. Perhaps it might take 2 or 3 years, but it will come. It might take a few months, but it will come. It might take a little bit longer or less, it will come. But that's if you're walking towards Allah. When we walk away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have none other to blame than ourselves. فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ. Whoever on the day of Qiyamah witnesses or sees anything besides paradise coming in their direction will have none other to blame but themselves. What did you do? You have a book that you are writing right now of your own deeds, and I have mine. We need to write some good stuff in there. Write some lovely things. There might be a few bad things. Allah Almighty knows you're a human, but Allah wants you to write some good things in there. You gave a charity, you fulfilled your 5 daily prayers, you changed your life. There was something very, very difficult to do because of the pressure of society and community and family and schools and whatever else. So much pressure for me to do the wrong thing, but oh Allah, I did the right thing. Now what do you want? Now what do you want? Allah, do you think He's going to be upset with you? It's going to be challenging, because if the Nabi of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, faced challenges when he was doing that which Allah instructed him to do with the help of Allah directly, do you think we are not going to face challenges to do the right thing? And what is the right thing, by the way? It is only purity. That's what it is. Morality, purity, high, top values, standards of character, conduct, and beautiful worship. That's all it is. There's nothing more to the deen of Allah than what I just mentioned now. Beautiful worship. Fulfill the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thereafter, develop yourself, your character, your conduct, your morals, your values. Stay away from haram. Wherever you have faltered as a human being, seek Allah's forgiveness. Hence we have the night of decree. Tonight might be the night, subhanallah, Laylatul Qadr. It might be the night. Search for it. Search for it by engaging in tawbah, repentance, seek Allah's forgiveness, praise Him, thank Him a billion times for what He's given you. That is a door to getting more. You thank Allah. You know, it reminds me of when a person comes and says, brother, I'm short of money, can you help me? Someone would say no sometimes. But if you say, brother, I'm short of 5p, you give me 5p, only 5p, not more than 5p, what would you do? You take out a pound, one coin, you say, take this, brother, gone. He says, thank you so much, Jazakallah, may Allah reward you, Allah grant you Jannah, you don't know what you've done for me. Really, you've helped me so much, I really appreciate what you've just done for me. It's going to change my life. You know what? Put your hand in your pocket, take out 50 quid and give the guy and say, you know, just take this, man. Ah, subhanallah. Why did he give you so much? Because the way you thanked him was crazy, man. He gave you 1 pound, it didn't mean a thing to him. For Allah to give you every single thing you ask, He says, if the first person I created right up to the last person I created was given every single thing that they ever asked for, it would not displace in my kingdom more than a pin or a needle would displace in terms of water if it were to be dipped into the ocean. That's the kingdom of Allah. Come on, you think Allah cannot give you? You ask Allah for one thing, He's already given you so many things you did not even pray for. Take a moment to think about those things and thank Him. And then see what He gives you. I was told I have 25 minutes, exactly 25 on the dot, my brother. May Allah bless all of us. Inshallah, we meet again just now. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.